deals with modeling a pharmacokinetics problem in which a person is basically modeled, and a person's bloodstream is modeled as a batch reactor. In this case, we have an anesthetic that can be administered in a bolus dose, which means in a large dose at the beginning, so it's like taking a pill. And then that's a single dose. And then after a certain amount of time, because of this elimination process, there will be a gradual removal of the drug from the patient's body, and eventually to a low enough level where the patient will wake up. Okay, in order to solve this problem, we need to basically model this chemical reactor with a material balance. And so we can do this with a simple batch reactor material balance. And I'll just call, since we don't need to refer to a particular component, I'll just refer to the concentration of the drug or the anesthetic in terms of this variable C. And so dC dt is equal to the net rate of formation of our anesthetic. And of course, it's not really after that initial bolus dose, we aren't really putting any more anesthetic in. And so this is just equal to the rate of elimination, which again is through a first order process, elimination process of Ke times the concentration. And so this is a first order integration problem. Write this as being C over C naught is equal to the exponential of negative Ke times T, where C naught is the initial concentration in the bloodstream. The initial concentration is basically this 250 milligrams. We'll assume that that's injected straight into the body. And so the initial concentration is 250 milligrams divided by 40 liters. The concentration that we want to know when we get to it is 4.5 milligrams per liter. We know the value of Ke times T, and we can solve for T. And the time at which the dose will cease being effective is about 1.6 hours. Okay, another method aside from doing a bolus dose is that we can do a bolus dose, and after that we will have constant infusion through an IV where we may slowly administer the drug and maybe stop when the surgery is over or about over. So here we have a case for part B where we want to achieve a steady state in the patient. So at steady state, a long time after the bolus dose is administered, we want to maintain the concentration at 4.5 milligrams per liter. And so to maintain this at 4.5 milligrams per liter, then we will need to write our basic balance on this reactor. And what that balance is, we only have two pathways through which we can accumulate or have material accumulate or be consumed for the system, right? And that's through flow in through the IV, which we're going to call that rate of flow I naught, and that will at steady state will balance elimination to keep us at a constant value of the drug in the bloodstream. This I naught is what we basically want to solve. Right, the rate of reaction is the same, that we just have a rate constant, K for elimination, times a volume here. So it's equal to the rate times the volume. This is the rate with which this rate is given on a per volume basis. So it's the rate with which material is consumed, with which the anesthetic is consumed. So we get the Ke times volume times the concentration, where Ke is again 0.2 reciprocal hours. The volume is 40 liters, and the concentration is 4.5 milligrams per liter. And so therefore, for the IV, when we solve for that, we get 36 milligrams per hour that we need to administer at long times. Okay, and so this, again, is the steady state level, and this problem was, as part of the problem B, was easy, relatively easy to solve, because we realized that what we were looking at for is a steady state solution. Of course, you might be interested in what the dynamic response would be. And just qualitatively, we can look at what's happening here, where this is the concentration of the bloodstream and this is time. When we do a bolus dose, you'll go to something above 4.5. And then without the IV, you'll decay back down to zero eventually and cross across 4.5 in too short a time. With the IV, you will gradually, you'll change what that steady state value will be so that it will come to 4.5 and then stop there as you're using the IV.